YouTube. What's going on? Trey back again, hit you all with a wonderful video. Hope you all are having a great week. Hope you all are having a great day so far. My week has been going very good, you know, and I want to send a special shout out to all the channel members, everybody that's a subscriber of the Trey King Show family. I greatly appreciate you all. We have a very unfortunate story, you all. Yes, a very unfortunate story. And I'm sorry, Florida, that it had to be you all once again. But for some reason, around this time of the year, around September to damn December, Florida just started acting up. But anyway, this story right here shows you the power of the G-spot. Now, who known that, you know, all this would have occurred from a guy getting a prostate exam. Basically, what he had busted when the doctor allegedly went too far up his anus and shot the poor doctor. But anyway, this is Grown Folks Talk. So what I need you all to do is get those sweet, precious, badass kids out the room right now, because I don't want nobody telling me, Trey, my child heard you say something and I don't like that. But anyway, get those kids out the room right now. Go ahead. Damn. It's soldiers, by the way. Okay, hopefully those kids are out the room by now. If they're not out the room by now, tough. Double D, Teddy. Yes, Double D. And today, for some reason, you know what I'm saying, I got with my team. They said, Trey, we have to take all sizes today. All sizes matter. So we'll take everything from a itty-bitty A all the way to a big old large GF, whatever the hell you call it. But anyway, if you're an A, do not get mad because y'all be in the comment section going off on me. But anyway, we have a man, 56 years old, yes, Amalo Johansson, who decided to take his Johnson to the doctor to get himself checked. And upon going to the doctor, he allegedly had ejaculated and cummed on himself while the doctor was proceeding to test his prostate. You might be saying, Trey, what is a damn prostate exam? Well, from what I've gathered and what I asked a few people, is that basically a doctor insert their finger, hopefully they don't have no long finger, up your anus, and they check to see if you have prostate cancer. And they said, man, it's very important to get, but I'm kind of skeptic. I'm kind of scared to get it my damn self, you know what I'm saying? So I had to call an expert up on the anus, yes. Not some doctor in an OBGYN or any kind of other male doctor. No, I had to call my cousin Tay Tay. You know what I'm saying? And for those who know my cousin Tay Tay on my daddy's side of Houston, big shout out to you, Tay Tay. I'm not trying to put you on the spot, but you're a professional. You know what you're talking about. You know, Tay Tay is gay, what we call a flaming, you know what. But anyway, he's proud of it. We, his family, we love him very much, and we accept him for exactly who he are until he starts talking about he's pregnant and really be number gas. Anyway, so I called Tay Tay and I asked him, I said, Tay Tay, what you know about this prostate exam? Tay Tay told me basically, look, he get a prostate exam done all the damn time. I wanted to hang up the damn phone, but that's my damn cousin. So I decided to listen. I said, around what age men go get it? He said, around their late 30s, 40s, and sometimes 50s. He said, some of them never go get it. And I said, now, is it true that you heard about guys ejaculating, you know what I'm saying, having an orgasm when they're, rectum is entered? He said, yes, all the time. I'm like, well, okay, Tay Tay, thank you very much, because he's about to go on somewhere else. Anyway, but anyway, Tay Tay, thank you very much for that message to me. I'm not going to tarry too long with this story. I'm going to read a quick snippet from this story, and we're going to explore some of these facts, and I'm going to give my opinion, all of it, surely, as we go. Man shoot his doctor after he made him ejaculate doing a prostate exam. Damn, man. Imagine that you be on this earth 56 years. All of a sudden, you go to the hospital, you didn't expect to bust one like that. The doctor put his finger, probably the long-ass fingers, too. And tell me this also, why do most doctors, not all, because you have some doctors who watch the channel and they'll correct me, why do most doctors have long-ass fingers? I mean, is it, like, predisposed genetic for doctors to have long fingers? Because I have seen this and heard this so many times. But anyway, the doctor put his finger up this man's ass, and this man basically got beside himself. But anyway, a Florida man, 56, shot his physician close range. Damn, I wonder what pistol he shot him with, the penis or the gun. Anyway, he shot the man twice in close range in the chest for making him climax during a prostate exam. Now, fellas, I know some of you all can't imagine that, but just try to imagine. I tried to imagine it, but I'm like, you know what? It's hard for me to imagine, because one thing about it, my ass ain't gonna let nothing enter, you know what I'm saying? But a lock and exit, if you know what I mean. This ass is made for exit, homie. Anyway, now on the day of the crime, which went down on August the 22nd, Milo Johansson sounded like somebody who would shoot the hell out of you. Sounded like somebody who's kind of undercover, too. Absconded in the state of Florida. Fortunately, the physician he shot survived the wounds. So thank God the physician that was shot survived, because one thing about it, I bet the doctor like, damn, I'm trying to help you feel good. I'm trying to save your life, and you're going to turn around and shoot the hell out of me? But anyway, now the doctor survived the gunshot wounds, and he have now recovered fully. Johansson, who was staying in Jacksonville as a used car salesman, had vanished without a trace. Where the hell is Johansson? We need to find Milo Johansson. Anyway, now he is presently a fugitive, and some folks think he potentially left the United States. Now, where in the hell did he go? That's what I want to know. Did he get on that big sausage headed to Paris or the UK? Where the hell did he go? Because I thought it was a lockdown, which meaning that you couldn't even travel to certain places. So I guess Milo must got the hookup from some damn body. But anyway, they say he vanished without a trace. He is presently a fugitive. Some folks think that he left the United States without a trace, like vanished without sight. Anyway, the doctor he fired upon notes for over 30 years he had been doing prostate exams and guys ejaculate all the time. But damn, I got a lot of questions to ask some of my people. I'm like, why didn't you tell me you was going to the damn doctor and everything? They were putting a finger in you and you was busting one off. I mean, I'm not trying to sound funny, but shit, I did not know this. Old as I am, I did not know that. I mean, I'm sorry, folks. I did not know that. That you can basically get your G-spot milk back there. I didn't even know men had a damn G-spot. Anyway, now, the men ejaculate all the time in the midst of the prostate exam, and one sexuality has nothing to do with it, which means that you could be a straight man. You know what I'm saying? You could be as hard as Iron Chest Charlie, and you could go in there and drop them draw, and a doctor examine you, and you could just explode everywhere, just shoot every damn well. But make sure that you keep yourself intact afterwards. Anyway, now the doctor says Milo needs help. Dr. Smith elaborated, the prostate is like a male G-spot, and it carries semen. It is in a very sensitive area, so when it is touched and massaged, you get an orgasm with almost no effort. So maybe that's why some people like playing with their butts. Maybe that's why some people like taking it up the anus. I mean, damn, do what you want to do, but at the same time, this is all new to me, so I'm just shocked as you all are, because I did not know that men had a damn G-spot. Like, what the hell are we going to find next, a T-spot? Anyway, the doctor goes on to say the prostate is only accessible through the anus, and that's very comfortable for most men. What kind of men? Shit, not me. Maybe those other kind of men, but not me, because, I mean, damn, my ass tight. I ain't afraid to say it, so all you women talking about, well, my vagina tight or whatever, total different comparison, but at the same time, your ass is supposed to be tight if you're a man. But I understand, you know, some people indulge in extracurricular activities and more power to them. But for the doctor to say that it's very comfortable for most men, what men? I don't know. What man find that comfortable with a man lubing up with KY jelly, running his finger up in him? Anyway, now the doctor says, I understand that Milo was shocked by what happened to him. An orgasm meant something sexual had taken place between us, and he became very aggressive. But damn, what do you expect? But at the same time, I have to question Milo too, like, Milo, I mean, damn, you couldn't think of something in your mind, like, you know, manly or something? I mean, damn, did he make you lose that much control? Or can you not help yourself when the doctor proceed to check your prostate? I mean, somebody let me know, because I know the older fellas out here that got their prostate exam. And I don't want to ask them to they ejaculate or not, because I'm not like that. But at the same time, it makes you wonder. You know what I'm saying? It makes you wonder. Anyway, so Milo Johansson felt played and basically ordered the doctor to apologize to him and basically say he was sorry and swear to keep this a secret. Anyway, like Alicia Keys said, your secrets are safe with me. Now, Dr. Smith claimed he was trying his best to calm Johansson and gently inform him it was a normal thing. However, he whipped out a pistol and busted two shots at him. You sure that was his gun or was it his other love-making gun, if you know what I mean? He shot the doctor and then fled. He was last seen in Jacksonville that day. His 29-year-old significant other said he phoned her and remarked, hasta la vista, baby. I guess the same thing, basically, on a Schwarzenegger doing this movie, like, goodbye or whatever. So, and that was the last time she heard from him. After that, his number was out of service. He hated homosexuals. I know that, but the shooting, I never thought he'd take it that far. So, basically, doctor, how did you know that he hated homosexuals? Did he tell you, did he instill in you, bestow upon you that he hate homosexuals? What made you come to that point? And also, what kind of damn exam did you give him to make a 56-year-old man ejaculate and then turn around and shoot you? I mean, damn, what was really going on in that damn room? Maybe it's more than meets the eye. But anyway, I'll keep you all updated as more of the story unfolds. And you all, you know, I'm not telling you to go get checked, but, you know, they say it's something that we should do because it does check for prostate cancer, RBS aside. But at the same time, imagine you fellas, if you up in there, and you consider a man's man like I am, you know what I'm saying, or whatever you want to call yourself, and then all of a sudden you feel something go up in there, and you just explode every damn well. How you going to go look at your woman the same way? How you going to go look at her the same way when she probably never even made you bust it hard? But anyway, you all let me know what you think in the comment section. If you like the video, push that like button. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel, become a channel member. And also, go get yourself checked. Women, go get yourself checked. But one thing I am mad at, I did not know us men had a G-spot. But anyway, you all let me know what you think in the comment section about this. And if there's anything you want to add to this, or if you know what Milo Johansson is, please, please notify the authorities. But anyway, y'all have a great weekend. Till next time, I'm out.